I'm going to begin by typing this formula myself rather than using the insert function as I did before. I find that when I'm doing more complicated formulas, it just helps me to see it and think my way through as I do it. So I'm going to click where I want my answer to go, and then I'm simply going to begin by doing the equal sign if. You know that whenever you're using one of the built-in functions, it next would begin with the open parenthesis. Instantly, Excel's trying to help me. It recognizes that the if statement I'm using is a logical function. It's highlighted and in bold, telling me that what I need now is the logical test. I'm going to click on the first cell that I want it to examine, and then I'm asking it to look and see if the number of homes sold was greater than or equal to 10. Comma. As soon as I do comma, it indicates again to me that what I should be typing in next is the value if true. And if they have 10 or more in quotes, because I'm doing words rather than numbers, remember, I am going to have to type in that they get the Golden Apple Award, end my quote, and as soon as I do a comma again, it tells me I'm ready for my value of false. But I want it to actually take a look and see, well, if it wasn't 10, if they didn't get 10 or more, how about 7 or more, and then 5, and then 4 or less, there'll be no award. So here's where I actually start nesting in another if statement. And so the false, in addition to being false for this if, will become the new condition or logical test for my next one. So I just begin as if I am starting all over again. I'm going to say if, open paren. It instantly switched the false into a new logical test as it's highlighted for me. And so, same thing, I'm going to then take another look at the same exact cell because remember, I'm going to copy this formula down and look at all of the cells individually. So, this one test has to be able to be applied to everything I want it to look at. And I want it this time to look and see if it is greater than or equal to 7, comma, what would I do if it's true? And in this case, they get the Silver Pear Award, comma. Again, I'm simply following the same logic. I'm starting my new if statement, and I can either type it myself or click on the cell to get it to type it in for me. And greater than or equal to 5 in this case, comma. If that's true, it's the Bronze Peach Award. And this time, value if false. If false, I don't want to nest any more formulas in. If I include nothing, which is allowable, it will simply put a zero in, but I would prefer that it actually leaves that cell blank. So I'm just going to do a begin and an end quote, which will cause it to leave that cell completely empty. And as I look at this, now my value of false, I'm down to my last test, and I'm going to want to use autofill to copy this formula down. So I'm going to use the check to enter it, and it instantly tells me I have an error in my formula. You'll see this sometimes. Notice that it asks me, and if you compared the difference between their formula and what they've recommended, if you look, we have three nested formulas inside this one. And for every function that I use, I begin with the opening parentheses. So I've got 1, 2, and 3 open parentheses, but I only have one closing parenthesis on the end. And note down here, it's saying, if you want me to fix it for you, I will. And the only change that it's going to make is to add on the two closing parentheses that I missed. So for every opening paren, when you get to the end, you must have a matching closing one. I'm going to say yes, let it fix that formula for me as I see it in the formula bar up here, but I'm going to copy and automatically fill the contents of the other cells in, and I get my answer. And if you look, it should be correct for the awards that they are receiving. Great formula, isn't it?